If I don't make it through this Christmas, have a drink on me, put all of my belongings under some poor family's tree. Dress me up like Santa, deck me out in mistletoe, sing oh hallelujah, and bury me in the snow.
What are you doing in here, lady? The store's closed. How'd you get in? Ma'am, I know you're not a mannequin. I just saw you blink.
Where's the try?
Wow. How'd you get in?
I didn't leave.
Snow away, huh? Hmm. Where?
Behind the drapes and home furnishings.
Ingenious.
So you gonna call the cops?
Do I need to?
No, no. Look, do you think I could stay maybe a little longer until you leave, perhaps?
So are you homeless, or?
No, not in the way you mean.
What other way is there?
Oh, you know.
Not really. No family?
Oh, yeah.
So you got a home and you got a family and it's 2 a.m. on Christmas morning.
But as they said, pet shelters are families for life, not just for Christmas. Except with dog or cat in the phrase.
So where are they?
In the living room.
Ah, and you're in Fantastic Deals Furniture.
Stuffing themselves stupid with cinnamon cookies or, no, by now passed out after a serious session of Christmas cheer.
So you got an argument with your husband?
No.
Mother-in-law?
Dad.
Kids?
No, don't have any.
So then who's in your living room?
No, my husband, George.
George?
My sister, assorted nieces and nephews, and weirdly out of the blue, my brother.
They don't know you've gone? When did you leave?
Have you ever slept on a fully orthopedic sleep number bed? I just had a little nap on one, and they're actually amazing.
No one's noticed you've gone?
Oh, they went to O'Flanagan's. It's a ritual. I stay home to peel and pulverize. They come home, carry on partying, and they think I'm in bed. I did leave a note under the tree to say that I could use a little help in the kitchen, and I'd gone to see if I could borrow an elf from Santa, and, that should take care of most of this morning, after they eventually surface, and probably well into this afternoon.
No one's called you?
Which they will spend in front of the game, like the Walking Dead. At halftime, they'll wonder where the ham is. I mean, no one will move, but they'll wonder.
Ham. And mashed potatoes?
And a white sauce with parsley.
Parsley. Oh, man, that sounds like my kind of home.
You want to go over? I can give you the address.
I'd love to, but...
Pressure cookers and timers really were marvelous inventions.
You still did all the cooking?
I have a weakness of character. I wonder if anyone will actually think to look in the oven.
So you don't hate them all?
No, why would you think that? It's not their fault I can't join in.
You can't. Then why are you here?
Because it's so much more appropriate. I managed to avoid Christmas entirely for years. But when you get married and you move to the burbs, it's expected of you. And this year, I opted out.
You opted out of Christmas?
Make a good song, right? I opted out of Christmas. La 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 la.
That eggnog coffee in that cup?
You can smell it from there?
Sadly, no. Got a little vodka in it, too. No, but Christmas is a great time of year. It's family time, it's a time for giving, and a time for forgiving.
Well, if you're so into it, why are you here? Haven't you got a family to be with? I'm sorry, that was, sorry. Look, why don't you have a seat and, what's your name?
Angela. Angela Weiss.
You're kidding me. Catholic mother, Jewish father?
Yeah.
My grandparents were that way too. Wow. Huh. I'm Holly.
Yeah. Well, the Catholics say take the religion from your dad, and the Jews say take the religion from your mom, so then you just end up confused
and celebrating nothing.
Or that too, maybe.
So you always had a blast at Christmas time, huh?
Sure, when I was a kid. Didn't you?
Sure, when I was a kid, then...
Then what?
Have some vodka nog and
then
a seat.
Then what?
Then you're not a kid anymore, and... You don't believe in any of it anyway. It is just a highly stressful, horribly commercial crap fest, right?
I can't.
Why not? Who's gonna know? Not like security's gonna get ya.
No, really. I can't.
Rules, huh? You a stickler for them too?
You're here illegally, trespassing.
Maybe that's why I'm here. I wanted to break some. Rules. I wanted to do something naughty and mischievous, like when we were kids.
You didn't have any rules when you were a kid?
Oh, sure, heaps of them. We broke them all the time. I can remember thinking that when I grow up, there will be no more rules. And then you just find out that there's different ones, worse ones, harder ones, ones that seriously guilt you out if you don't follow them.
Ah, like having to cook for everyone all through Christmas.
Like having to be merry.
You don't like being merry?
Not at Christmas.
Why is that?
You know, we used to come here all the time when I was little. We used to get to run riot after closing time. We'd hide in all the closets and we'd jump on all the beds and we'd get to play like it was...
Christmas?
Exactly! I don't get to play anymore.
How come?
I have weakness of character thing, I suspect.
No, how come you're able to play in fantastic deals after hours?
My dad was the manager.
And?
And he used to pretend not to notice for at least 10 minutes before he'd stop us.
And?
And he loved to play word games. We used to make stupid jokes out of the brand names, you know. Like Sealy Beds.
Or, if you're Italian,
a Sealy Beds!
And then? Then what?
And then he died, okay? That Christmas time, in fact, if you must know. There we were one minute about to open presents, pretending like we were the Waltons, and the next, the man who used to dress up as Santa in his red dressing gown, shaving foam beard, is lying on the shag carpet going a very un-Christmassy shade of gray.
So now?
So now, everyone assumes it's okay now. You know, it's supposed to be okay now, right? Because it was so long ago. And the thing is, for me, it just isn't. He always used to say, Holly, you're gonna give me a heart attack. That year, we sure had a killer Christmas.
It really is a bummer.
If you don't believe in any of the God stuff, it's not like praying's ever an option. It's not like he went somewhere, is somewhere, he just...
Well, maybe you should reconsider that, Holly Bud.
What?
I said maybe...
What did you just call me?
Bud?
As in buddy?
Holly. Holly Bud, Bud on the Bush. Play on words. Yeah, I was young too once. You know, it's pretty neat. They let you appear in your prime.
Dad! Are you real?
Well, real is sort of relative.
Yes, but am I...
No, you're not dreaming, if that's what you're thinking.
Oh my God.
Yeah. It's a bit of a shock for me too.
You can't,
It's a whole matter versus... immaterial space-time continuum thing.
Right.
You want to go home now? They'll be worried sick.
Can you come too? Do you see us? Oh my God, what's it like? There's no Jesus or Krishna or Muhammad or...
I can't.
Wow, a lot of rules.
Yeah, it's kind of a karmic system.
You can stay with me a while, though, right?
I think so. Never gotten this far before.
I'm meant to be here. This was planned?
I didn't know what for, but sort of been waiting.
Sorry I'm late.
Sorry I ruined Christmas.
Sorry I kept yelling and yelling.
Sorry I smoked 2 packs a day.
Even though I could see your face was going really big.
None of it matters now. None of it. Of course. It's Christmas. This is your gift. Nothing matters except this. Happy season of goodwill, Holly Bud. So, we good now? Do you want to go up to the 5th floor and trash Santa's grotto?
Oh my god, can we?
So, George, really?
He's a good guy.
Yeah, well, now I get why I had to collect his mom after she kicked the bucket.
You did? You could never stand her.
Yeah, like I said, it's a kind of comic system. This Christmas, there'll be those who will grieve, but they'll be getting over it in time for New Year's Eve. So crack the champagne open, toast the year and me goodbye. I'll be with God.